Some table models don't enforce their foreign key references by a foreign key constraint. This is a bad practice that often leads to foreign key references that point to non-existing records. When Hibernate tries to resolve such a broken reference, it throws an EntityNotFound exception. You should therefore define a foreign key constraint for every foreign key reference. But after someone decided against using foreign key constraints and deployed the application to production, that decision is often hard to reverse, and that puts you in the position where you need to build a persistence layer that can handle associations that reference a non-existing record. By default, Hibernate throws an exception if it tries to resolve a broken foreign key reference. The best way to fix this is, of course, to clean up your database and fix your foreign key references. But if that's not an option, you need to decide if you want to handle an EntityNotFound exception every time you call the getter method of a potential broken association, or use Hibernate's NotFound annotation to tell Hibernate to fetch a potentially broken association and ignore it or throw a FetchNotFound exception when instantiating your entity object. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. If you want to build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring Data JPA, please subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. Annotating an association with Hibernate's proprietary NotFound annotation has three effects. Hibernate assumes that the table model doesn't define a foreign key constraint for that association and doesn't generate one if it generates the table model. You define if Hibernate shall ignore broken foreign key references or throw an exception, and Hibernate fetches the association eagerly even if you set its fetch type to lazy. I will get into more details about Hibernate's enforced eager fetching in the next part. First, let's take a closer look at the NotFound annotation and the two supported NotFound actions. You can define the NotFound action exception by annotating the attribute that maps your association with NotFound and setting the action attribute to exception, or keeping it empty. This tells Hibernate to throw a FetchNotFound exception if it can't resolve the foreign key reference. This behavior might seem very similar to the one you get without annotating your association with NotFound, but there are two differences. Hibernate throws a FetchNotFound exception instead of an EntityNotFound exception, and Hibernate ignores the configured fetch type and tries to fetch the association eagerly to validate the foreign key reference. Due to that, Hibernate throws the FetchNotFound exception when it instantiates the entity object, and not when you use the association for the first time. This makes the FetchNotFound exception a little easier to handle. You can see all of this in the log output when I use the mapping in a test case that fetches a chess game entity with a broken foreign key reference. Hibernate joins and selects the player black association in the query that fetches the chess game entity and throws a FetchNotFound exception. Setting the NotFound action to ignore enables you to handle the broken foreign key reference in your business code. Instead of throwing an exception if it can't resolve the foreign key reference, Hibernate sets the association attribute to null. Due to that, you can no longer distinguish if an association wasn't set or if it's referencing a record that no longer exists. You need to decide for your application if you want to handle these two cases differently. If that's the case, you can't use NotFound action ignore. When you then execute the same test case as in the previous section, Hibernate no longer throws an exception and initializes the player black attribute with null instead. I mentioned earlier that annotating an association with NotFound changes the fetching behavior to fetch type eager. That's even the case if you explicitly set fetch type lazy in your association mapping, like I did in the previous examples. The reason for that is simple. Hibernate needs to use fetch type eager to ensure that it only initializes the association attribute if it references an existing entity object. If you don't annotate your association attribute with NotFound, Hibernate expects that a foreign key constraint validates the foreign key reference. Due to that, it only needs to check if a foreign key reference is set. If that's the case, it knows that it will be able to resolve the reference and initializes the entity attribute with a proxy object. When you use that proxy for the first time, Hibernate will execute an SQL statement to resolve the foreign key reference. If you annotate the association attribute with NotFound, Hibernate can no longer trust the foreign key reference. Without a foreign key constraint, the reference might be broken. Hibernate therefore can't simply use the foreign key value to instantiate a proxy object. It first needs to check if the reference is valid. Otherwise, it would need to set the association attribute to null. Performing this additional query can create performance problems, but there's only a minimal performance difference between checking the foreign key reference and trying to fetch the associated entity. Due to that, the Hibernate team decided to use eager fetching for all associations annotated with NotFound. The enforced eager fetching of Hibernate's NotFound mapping can cause performance problems. Even though the implementation might be more complex, it's often better not to annotate your association with NotFound and handle the broken foreign key reference in your business code. Hibernate then instantiates a proxy object if the foreign key reference is set and tries to resolve it when using the proxy object for the first time. If the foreign key reference is broken, Hibernate throws an entity not found exception, which you need to handle in your business code. The obvious downside of this approach is that you need to handle this exception in various places in your business code. You need to decide if you're willing to do that to get the performance benefits of fetch type lazy, or if you prefer the ease of use provided by Hibernate's not found mapping. If you decide to handle the broken foreign key references in your business code and use Hibernate to generate your table model, you need to tell Hibernate not to generate the foreign key constraint. You should only use this if you're working on a legacy application that doesn't use foreign key constraints. If you still have the choice, you should always use a foreign key constraint to enforce your foreign key references. You can deactivate the generation of foreign key constraints by annotating your association with a join column annotation and setting the foreign key attribute to foreign key constraint mode no constraint. This annotation only affects Hibernate's generation of the table model and has no effect at runtime. Your table model should validate all foreign key references by a foreign key constraint. This ensures that new foreign key references can only reference existing records and that you can't remove a record that's still referenced. Unfortunately, some architects and development teams decide to avoid foreign key constraints. Sooner or later, these databases contain broken foreign key references, which you need to handle in your entity mappings or business code. If you want to handle them in your entity mappings, you can annotate an association with not found that tells Hibernate not to expect or generate any foreign key constraint. Hibernate then fetches the association eagerly to check the validity of the foreign key reference. The handling of a broken reference depends on your not found action. Hibernate can either ignore it and initialize the attribute with null or throw an entity fetch exception. If you prefer to handle the broken foreign key references in your business code, you can annotate your association attribute with join column and define the constraint mode no constraint. Hibernate then doesn't generate a foreign key constraint when generating the table model. At runtime, it doesn't check the foreign key reference until the generated proxy object tries to resolve it. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate and JPA, you should join the Persistence Hub. It gives you access to all my video courses, including one about Hibernate performance tuning, 2 monthly Q&A calls, monthly coding challenges, a community of like-minded developers, and regular expert sessions. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!